Hello everyone, and welcome to this time a premier draft of Crimson WoW, and seems like I get to open with a bomb rare once again. Dreadfeast Demon is, well, obviously a 7 drop, but if you get to resolve this so that you have non-demon creatures, even one on the battlefield, and the opponent doesn't have instant speed removal before your end step, you basically win the game, most likely. And I don't think there even are that many demons in this set, so most creatures should be, if not all, non-demons. Alright, so there's also a very good black removal spell I'm passing. The pack is actually rather weak. I do like the Flame Breather because the blue-red nice non-creature spell deck. Of course, this is one of the basic building blocks of it, so this could go early too, but the Parasitic Grasp is most likely going to be the second card that's gonna be picked here, but I'm not gonna not pick the Bomb Raider just because of that possibility. Alright, this is an interesting pack actually, because I like the Pack Song pop for one reason. It is that green has the mana acceleration, max mana accelerating for the Dreadfeast Demon, so it kind of works. This card works very well in a green black deck. But there is also the Skull Scarb, really decent card. But I'm not sure. There's also the Rotside Carganger. There's also another good green card. I mean, black doesn't have any Wolves or Werewolves, so you would be relying on green a lot to make this thing grow. So maybe I think that I'll take the Skull Scarb here instead. But you could take the Pack Song Pop here, I think. Also, if red-green would be open, that would be of course a fantastic pick. But let's see if this... Oh, now there's a Wolf King Outcast too. That could have been a sweet deck. I mean, if I took the Pack Song Pop there, that would be very nice two uncommons for the green wolf slash werewolf archetype here, but I took the blue-black build around uncommon. This is also not the strongest of these 10 uncommon golden cards, but it is still quite good if you get a bunch of exploit for your deck. Now, I mean, it's kind of hard to pick the outcast now when I, you know, when I have these cards. If I took the pop, it would be the easiest pick there. Here I have to think about something like a 4-drop Evolving Wild, Gift of Fangs. I quite like the Socialite, maybe I should just take it here. Although it is a 4-drop quite early, but I don't like the Gift of Fangs that much. This is also a premier draft, so there's no sideboarding. I usually don't want to play more than one Gift of Fangs in my deck. So it's quite early to pick that thing. Alright, so there is some blue here. Actually, two good blue uncommons, and no, not really anything green, so now it doesn't actually bother me that much that I didn't take the pop and then the Wolf King outcast there. This is a kind of an indication that blue is open, and I think out of these two options, I like the rejection more. Doomed Dissenter would be nice to get around the table if I get to utilize the Skull Scarb here, but yeah, let's take the good bounce spell here, nothing wrong with that, and okay, well, I'm no longer sad about passing the green cards, because green is pretty dry here, and blue is very open. Can't say a lot about black yet, because Mind Leech goal is definitely not amazing, it's not like a signal at all. So what is the pick in here? I could take another rejection, Chill of the Grave, Scattered Thoughts. I think I like the bounce spell still most, but there are multiple good options here. Okay, it seems like black isn't quite that open, but I do have the Dreadfeast Demon here. White, blue maybe is the most open archetype here, because the Drog Skull Infantry here is still, along with the Militia Rallier and the playable removal spell, nothing too... I mean, it's not an amazing card, but it's a fine card. Alright, so am I gonna take the white here now? Am I gonna potentially move away from black at all altogether? I mean, there is a pointed discussion, and that's about it. Blue, if I'm blue-black, I might get those blue card draw spells. I think I take the what is in my opinion the best card in the pack and just take the white 2-drop. If white would have been open, doesn't seem like it based on this pack. That would have been a reasonable pick here. But now I don't have any white here. Now this deck, because of the 7-drop, could play an unarmed heirloom. I'm not gonna take it here because there's a Chill of the Grave. There's also the Arch Goal of Thraben. But it's not really... It hasn't really impressed me too much. You don't need to hit a zombie. The ability to boot a card to the graveyard is still a kind of okay death trigger, but it's still just a 3-mana 3-2. So let's take the Chill of the Grave, which I do like quite a bit more here. Okay, now there's a Heron of Hope. There's also Kessick Flimbreather quite late, but I don't think that's the pick I'm going to make here. Now with the double Lunar Rejection and the Chill of the Grave, I think this is a syncopate deck. With this instant speed stuff, that easily can play a syncopate here. It also is good with the bounce in general. I can bounce some problematic creature and then counter it with a syncopate. Alright, so here I think it's rather easy Scattered Thoughts over the Retrieval and the Mind Leech goal. Although I wouldn't mind to have the 2-drop here. And it does synergize a bit with the Skull Scar, but I like the card draw spell, especially because I want to hit my land drops for the Dreadfist Demon, so it makes total sense to take a bit of card draw here. And here, the Rotside Gargantua, I like it more than the Cruel Witness here. I do also want to have some exploit creatures to combine with the Skull Scar here, so... I mean, I don't think the Rotside Gargantua is bad at all. I think it's time to pick a 3-mana fixing card here, Evolving Wilds. Okay, a Doomed Descender. That was fantastic to get back because now I'm happier to have some... Wait a second. I don't think I'm gonna play the Siphon Essence. I'd rather play even 2 Scattered Thoughts than one... Than a Siphon Essence in addition to the Syncopate. But yeah, I'm of course happy to get this exploit. Kind of assisting cards that assist me my exploiting here. Quite nice pick up there. So I mean, because it was like pick number 12 or something very late anyway. All right, here I do like the Gluttonous Quest, but for this kind of a defensive deck, of course my game plan with the double Scattered Thoughts and the Bomb Rare is just to buy some time to get to play my cards. That gave me a long late game advantage. But the Diagraph Scavenger is really good. Now the pick is easily between the Scavenger and the Gluttonous Quest here. I'm not exactly sure which one I should have. I suppose this is a zombie. I have some zombie synergy. I could have some more maybe. I think the Death Touch blocker, the Drain Life, all that is quite decent. And even though I like the quest a lot, I prefer the 2-3 now. Consuming Tide, not really a good card. It's so random when this can be good. Usually it's not, so not really anything I want to draft around. Okay, but this pack has a lot of decent options. The Lantern Bearer, the Stitched Assistant, and the Rotted Gargantua, which is still fine. I really want to have the Assistant, but the Lantern Bearer is also something you can exploit, so it is actually in a similar card to the Doomed Descender, a nice creature you can exploit, and then it still will be valuable after the fact that it has been sacrificed. So I think I'll take the Bearer because there's a decent chance that I might get the Stitched Assistant, and if I don't, I still can get a Gargantua, maybe the Retrieval or something like that. But I take the 1-mana flyer here now, and I should definitely cut Drock Skull Infantry. There's no reason to keep it there. All right, so here. I think the Mind Leech goal here is now fine. I want to have 2-drops. So it's a 2-drop that can synergize a bit with the other cards. Scarp, the Repository Scarp doesn't seem currently very good because I don't want to really return my card draw spell. I would want to return removal spells, but I haven't got really a lot of them. Okay, Catapult Fodder, Dying to Serve. I don't think I will be discarding a lot. There's not a ton of blood token generating here. Yeah, I think this is an easy Catapult Fodder. I'm not sure how many creatures with more toughness than power I will have, but it's just a good blocker here. That might be enough to run in this deck. So let's take it. And I might focus a bit more on creatures that have more toughness than power. That said, the Wanderlight Spirit isn't really the kind of card I'm looking to play in this deck. That is mostly just a very defensive deck, so I think I like the Chill of the Grave more than the Binding Geist. I haven't been impressed by the Binding Geist much at all. I guess in a very aggressive deck it might be good. I don't care, I just take the Chill of the Grave here. And now I will take a Gift of Fangs. I want to have access to maybe exactly one of those. The Cat Geist isn't so great when you don't have a lot of evasion, and I don't actually have. So I don't think the Cat Geist is the card I want. I think it's a bit too late to start picking the Throngs here, and I'm not even that convinced it's even that great, even if you get like three of them. So yeah, I think this is not the deck for the Cat Geist. So I'll just take another 2-mana 2/2 that can, you know, sometimes do something with the exploit here. Here, Siphon Essence again offered to me, but I think the Specimen might be the card I'm taking here now if I get more of those exploit stuff. And I saw the one pack that had a lot of them. I don't want to play two of these specimens, and I still don't want to have the Wanderlight Spirit, so I take another Gift of Fangs, but I think it's easy to cut. So now I think this next pack should be the one that had the 3-mana exploit creature, 5-mana exploit creature, and the repository scab. So someone took the Stitcher's Assistant, which I would have actually wanted to have here most, but I think the second Gargantua is still fine. Just let's hope to find something like more Doomed Dissenters, and I'm happy at that point. I'm not going to play any of these cards, and there's no sideboard consideration, so I'll take the uncommon just there. And there's a Fear of Death. I could play that, so let's pick that. And there's another Spirit. Now I can pick it because that was really the only option for me. And there's an Edgar, Charmed Groom, very good card, and I have one Evolving Watch for the splash. So now the question is, I could get the Unearthed Heirloom back. I guess if I had two of these Evolving Wilds, I would be a bit happier about it. Now I might just want to take the Diagraph Scavenger and not mess up my mana too much here. Yeah, this is also a decent 4-drop, so let's take it. Decent and defensive, which works for this deck quite nicely. Okay, wow. Darn, what a pack. I really wanted to take the Felstinger, but can I pass a bleed dry? Felstinger is actually... well, it's not maybe that amazing here. There's also, by the way, the Desperate Farmer. That would be a nice pickup. And the Assistant. Hopefully I get something back here. At least the Assistant. I don't expect to get the Stinger back, of course. But Bleed Dry has to be the pick here, right? Yeah, it really has to be the pick. Such a good removal spell. And now... well, not so exciting pack this time. But I guess the Catapult Fodder can still be taken here. It's nice... a defensive card, like I said, and this deck should have very good late game, so let's take the 3-mana 1/5 here. Whispering Wizard, third Gargantua. 11 non-creatures, I don't know how many of them I'm gonna play, but I'm still taking the Whispering Wizard here. That's a lot of 4-mana cards, though. That really is. Okay, do I want to have the cheap bounce spell or something like another Evolving Wilds here? It's definitely not gonna be the pointed discussion, because I have... two Scattered Thoughts, although I might cut off one of them, but I'm still not gonna play the discussion. I guess I have 2 Lunar Rejections, but that's a lot of expensive cards there. But I guess I'll still take the Evolving Wilds here, because I have actually quite a few cards here, 27. I have a lot of cuts to make anyway, so I don't necessarily have room for that. Cheaper Bounce Spell. Okay, I get a Parasitic Grasp pick 6 here. Soul Cipher board is too slow and clumsy for this deck, but this is fantastic pick up here, a nice removal spell. And sadly I got a Wild Spawn Spider. I wish I could have more of these Skull Scarps here. Here I'm not gonna play any of this stuff. I don't need the 4-mana 3/3 flyer for this deck. I want my 4-drops to be more defensive in nature, so I'll just take a random uncommon here. I'm not gonna play 2 Syncopates. One is... I probably will play the one... well, it's still a card I could cut here. I mean, I can't be sure yet. Let's see how this looks like when I'm building the deck. All right, so Edgar's Awakening. Well, I mean, if I had a way to discard this Dreadfeast Demon, it would be an interesting one, but I don't have any blood tokens really to synergize with it. But I'm not gonna play three of these Rot-Tide Gargantuas either. So let's take the Awakening, but it's most likely I'll put it to the sideboard right away. Okay, the Heirloom. Don't think I have room for that. Now, probably. Although, maybe 17 lands and an Heirloom could be an interesting consideration here. Scarp. No, I have 2 5 drops already. I'll take the Heirloom because I just don't think the Cruel Witness is for this deck. Okay, Stitched Assistant I'm definitely taking. But yeah, this is I can block flyers with it, of course, but it's still against ground creatures, it's a very bad blocker and I'm not a very aggressive deck here. Okay, do I need another 2 drop here? I might actually need. The Scarp is, I guess it can help me, you know, flip the fodders here, but I guess I might actually need a 2 drop here. Well, I got now a 3rd Gargantua, which I'm not gonna play. Trick. I don't have room for any of this, so I'm not gonna play them, no matter what. Yeah, the Awakening is too expensive. Don't have a lot of synergy for it. Don't think I have any ways to discard this thing. It would be nice to reanimate, of course, with 5 mana, but I don't even have the crappy looters, the 1/3s for 2, that only can discard a creature card. Yeah, this actually isn't a very impressive deck. I didn't get the kind of the tools I wanted to have. I have like 3 Mind Leech goals, but only 1 Doom Dissenter, for example, so I don't think I'm gonna often sacrifice anything for this, because it usually isn't worth sacrificing a creature to make the opponent exile a card from their hand. Yep. So let's go the okay. This view in here, and I start cutting some cards. This is often a 3 mana card. These are often 4 mana cards. Yeah, I mean, I have to play the goals because I want to have these 5 2 drops at least. Right. So, well, Wanderlight Spirit is the easiest cut here. I don't think I'm going to play the Heirloom here. And the Repository Scarp, too expensive. The Blood-Crazed Socialite. So I have these Diecraft Scavengers. These are really good defensive creatures. Now I will play the Whispering Wizard. And I think, yeah, I guess the Socialite is gonna go away. I picked it quite early, but I'm gonna cut it now anyway. One of the Gargantuas goes away. One of the Gift of Fangs goes away. And I guess the Syncopate is not so interesting anymore because I still need some cuts here. Okay, cut that one. I will play the Specimen because I have, you know, some number of these exploit creatures still. I kind of want to play the Fear of Death to have some cheap interaction still. The Catapult Fodder isn't going to... I mean, I guess I can... Does this work? No, I mean, what's the... I mean, just trying to... Come on, how do I see the... Do I not see the... Is it power smaller than toughness? No, I mean, this probably doesn't work. Like this. It's not smart enough of a system. I guess power equals 2. Yeah, that works, but you can't. And you can put power less than 3, for example, but you can't say power less than toughness, I guess. Or did I make a typo there? Yeah, it doesn't. But if I put toughness equals 2, yeah, it doesn't work the way I want it to. So I guess I can just manually check it out. The number of creatures that have more toughness than power. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's it. So these are not gonna actually transform. Well, it's very rare that they would be transforming. So It doesn't seem that great. I'm not going to play the Unhallowed Phalanx or the Vandalite Spirit just to make it easier to transform these guys. So how do I do it? How do I do it? They are still okay blockers in here. But I have to cut. I mean, I'm gonna play 17 lands for sure because of the 7 drop here. So I will cut 3 more cards. I mean, the 4 drops are just... The 4 drops have the most of them, so... I guess it has to be. I mean, this is even lying a bit because it counts the Lunar Rejections as the 2 mana cards, which they always are not. Wow. How many zombies do I have? 11. Well, at least my Chill of the Graves will often be 2 mana cards, but not on turn 2. There's no way for them to be castable at 2 mana on turn 2 because I have no 1 mana zombies here. But still, these often will be cheaper. Right. So, I mean, I have to cut at least 2 of these 4 mana cards. I did cut the Syncopate, so maybe one of the Lunar Rejections just has to go. I do want to have the Whispering Wizard. But I don't want to cut too many of non-creatures either. I mean, then the Whispering Wizard won't be that good. Yeah, that's actually true. If I cut a Whispering Wizard... Does that make any sense? Because then... I kind of don't want to cut my... 3 drops just because they are decent blockers, even though they are not gonna transform. Really. Do I not want to play 2 of these Gargantuas? That's actually something I could do. Cut 1 of the Gargantuas. Fine. That seems like a reasonable thing to do. And then, I guess the 1-5 is just not so good because it's not gonna transform. So let's see. If I do this, is this too crazy? Because I have now not a lot of early game available here. And the stuff that I have early are like 2 mana 2/2s, which are not that good. But then at 4 mana I can start doing some stuff. And sometimes these will be 2 mana cards too. But it is a premier draft, so I can't really adjust my deck of the sideboarding. Because I could see playing 2 Gift of Fangs. Actually, that might even make sense here. I mean, maybe I'll do it like this. I will cut one of the Scattered Thoughts. These are actually at least interaction that sometimes will be cheaper, and then I can play what the second Gift of Fangs, just because my early game is so bad. I don't have any vampires here, so I will have to use this as -2/-2 effects, but that's what you want to do with them. The Fear of Dead isn't that great, but... I guess that's it now. I'll play it like this. I'm not too happy. The blue-black archetype isn't the strongest in this set, but it can be good. But I guess I needed more of those good uncommons that work well with this stuff. So this deck is mostly about, you know, getting the Dreadfist Demon. I don't even have that much exploit synergy here because I have one Skull Scarp. I don't have the Biolum Egg or anything like that. So this deck just seems pretty bad. I'm thinking about the Fear of Death, if I should cut it after all. Play something else instead, but is that gonna make any sense? I mean, it's quite negative synergy with the Rotside Gargantua too. I don't like it. I'm gonna cut it and play something else. Maybe one of the 1/3s. Man, this deck is not good. I'll just have another 5/4 here. That's it. Now I'm done. 15 black, 9 blue. Let's play these. And I have a black double cast. There's no blue double casters, so pretty easily. Don't even have that many blue cards here now that I cut a lot of the blue. Yeah, fine. I'm just thinking about if I want to even play 2 of these Gargantuas. Should just play maybe 2 Scattered Thoughts. I'm really not sure. This deck isn't really. I mean, it's gonna have flaws no matter what. I wish I just had more 3 drops, some creatures here. Maybe the a gluttonous quest, for example, would have been quite nice instead of these 1/3s that aren't gonna transform. Yeah, it's gonna be tough to get any great value out of my cards here, but I guess I can sacrifice these random 2/2s for the Gargantua in the end, so I'll play it like this. And I add here now some basic lands here. So 8 swamps and 7 islands. Probably good enough. Yeah, alright. I'm not excited by this deck. If I get to 3 wins, that's gonna be good for me, I'd say. Okay, well, this hand is somewhat okay. There's no value to be gained from the Skull Scarp here. Okay, blue, black, there are two. They have a dissenter, which I would want to have. Well, there's my way to win the game. Let's see if I'm gonna get to 7 mana here. Well, I didn't have any exploit there, so it doesn't matter too much. But now there's like a Gift of Fangs and a Gift of Fangs. Alright, so how do I do it? I guess I'll take 2 here. Maybe they'll play around a counterspell or something like that. I don't even have the double black for this Bleed Rise or the Parasitic Grasp, which can kill the human, but obviously Doomed Dissenter is not the kind of card you're gonna use removal on. Mind Leech Goal. Well, I will exile a Gift of Fangs here. But this is already... Although I need the Gift of Fangs to get rid of these 2/2s, I guess. Huh. Guess I'll cut the Parasitic Grasp instead, because I can't cast that. Alright, so this is now gonna eat the... Oh, actually I could have considered to killing the Lantern Bearer, but now I'll play my 2/3 here. They are stuck at 2 lands, which means that when they start drawing lands, they have a lot of spells there. Can't even raise them, because if I attack for 2, they will attack for 5. Now I get the Stitched Assistant. Well, I guess I'm going to use this on the goal. I just played a 3 mana 3/2, I think. Okay. So be it. Will they make me exile a card from my hand? If they are, I'm gonna lose the Gift of Fangs here, most likely. So, do that. And then I'll play the Stitched Assistant. I will now try to raise them a bit. I have the Bleed Drive if they make the Mind Leech Goal a flyer. I guess I could sacrifice this Assistant to draw a card, Scry and draw, but we'll see. Are they gonna use the Lantern Bearer here? If they are, I guess they can use it on the 2/2 here, but no, they have a Binding Geist. Well, that's not great either. It's actually good against the Diecraft Scavenger here. Well, this is just miserable. I'm not going to even draw my lands for the Red Fist Demon. I mean, did I keep a 3-lander? I think I did to keep a 3-lander. I have drawn 1 card out of these 6. Slevon land out of these 6 cards I have drawn, so... no point attacking with anything, I'm just gonna, you know, chill here and try to be on the defensive here. Problem is they can use the binding geist from the graveyard to neutralize my scavenger. I don't want to start taking three from this thing either. Yeah, I guess I just hope to draw three swamps, you know, back to back. I wasn't able to punish them for you know, not hitting their land drops because my own start was really miserable too here. And I would really prefer to have my second gift of thanks and the parasitic grasp here, by the way. I exiled two removal spells. So now, if I do... I'll just take the three for now. Okay, there's a lantern bearer at least, so... So let's see how I'm gonna block now. I mean, this game is of course winnable totally with the Dreadfish Demon, but I just need to hit my lands and I need three of them. I guess I could draw a card, draw a spell too. That would help. Now they're gonna planters leave that thing and I will need to bleed dry. Oh, the one of the bounce spells would be nice too. Let's see if that is going to happen or not. Okay, I'll take the four here still. I need to draw a swamp here. Well, that works, so I'm gonna bounce it right away. I might have to exile yet another card, but that's it. No land still. Do I need the lantern bearer here? I might actually do this even. They can attack with the binding guys, they can block with the stitched assistant. Let's try to be a little bit aggressive here. Thing is, I might exile the Dreadfish Demon here. Try to win with the Whispering Wizard and that it makes some flying tokens. Not really sure, because the Dreadfish Demon is the late game win condition, but I'm not sure if this game is going to go to that stage, because opponent has 5 spells. Okay, this is just insane. So I'm gonna have to exile the Dreadfish Demon here, and let's see me drawing 3 lands back to back, because these I'm more likely to be able to cast at some point. Wow, I mean, whatever. I'll play the Whispering Wizard. Hope to get a couple of my cantrips or something like that. I'm gonna win with the 1-1 tokens here. And that is exactly what started happening. At least that was not a... that wasn't a... you know, it wasn't a swamp, but still. I just look at the cards I have exiled in this deck. These are all from discard effects. Well, not discard, but you know, exile from my hand. 2 premium removal spells, and then 1 cost-effective removal spell, and the bomb rare, all been exiled from hand. I guess I can hope they can sacrifice a binding geist here to make me exile the island here. Then they can make the death toucher into a 0 power guy. I didn't need the island there. So there is that. I have a couple of those cantrips, you know, the ones that I draw me a card, make them tap their creature and make them not untap in the next untap step. Okay, now there is a swamp. Alright, so now I still am not too excited about offering the trade on the Mind Leech goal here. Let's just attack for 1 here. And maybe they have more of that stuff. I do have double caster still. I have the Gargantua. I'm not gonna let them know that I have a land in my hand. I wish I can make some 1-1 flyers with the wizard. But the opponent has 5 cards. Okay, they have a Blood Whale per bear. So my removal has been Yeah, well, that's it. Game over. Can't beat that, and it's I start drawing now my lands. So that was a really awkward game. Dreadfeast Demon, of course, doesn't do anything if you don't draw the lands for it, unsurprisingly. But I had a lot of draw steps in that game. I just was a bit unlucky in that sense. Let's see if the next game is gonna go better. I don't wanna play against those discard effects. Well, I have the Dissenter here. I don't have the blue mana source this time. I'm gonna keep it because I have still these playable cards. And of course they have a fast start here. Okay, now I do have it. So what is the first card? Because I want to have the Skull Scarp and the Dissenter on the battlefield and then play the Might Leech Gold. If they have a Syncopate, I'm gonna be rather sad. I'll play just this thing. Okay, they are mono blue currently. Okay, Bleach Dry. I just have to. If they have counter spells, then they do. I'll do this now, and they don't. So, am I gonna be greedy here? I'm gonna be greedy here. I'm not gonna sacrifice anything right now, because the Mindless Goal is slightly better. This only works when I sacrifice a non-token. So, if I did sacrifice this now, I would have a 2-2 token. Okay, well, Gift of Fangs is going to actually. Okay, look at this. This is really good now. Alright, lucky me, because I can play this and they'll give Gift of Fangs here, so let's do it. Although, first I should attack for 3 here, right? So let's do. Well, they have like slightly more information. This is not a vampire. But I get to deal 3 now. If I first do the Mind Leech Gold, then I won't be dealing 3. Now, let's kill it. And now I will have a quite nice board. I mean, the opponent is missing some color here, unless they are mono blue. So this is now, I mean, I get 2 tokens here and they have to exile a card from their hand. So, and I have a very decent hand here. So it does seem like, unless they have something very sick, they have red here. A rich wolf there. So they are not mono blue, but they have 3 cards left. They have a Diver's Carpets they are most likely going to use to sacrifice the Lantern Bearer. But it's fine because I have the Chill of the Grave. Do they get rid of a token here? They do. And now I can just chill this guy. Keep attacking here. And then I can bounce and all that, okay. Again, not drawing any lands here, but this is quite fine. When I do draw a land, I can play the Bleed Dryer too. Okay, they can upgrade that guy. Doesn't help yet. Okay. Let's attack for 5 here still. And now, kind of interesting. Drycraft Scavenger is really good, but they could have a counter spell. But, I mean, they didn't have earlier, so. Okay, they do. Sadly. Siphon Essence there. It would have been nice to get rid of this Lantern Bearer, but I didn't really want to play just a 1 mana spell here. I'm still, of course, totally winning here, because I can get rid of the Diver's Cup with the Bleed Dry. So let's see what else they're gonna have, because I mean, I guess I can just bounce it too. Let's bounce it. Okay, another scavenger will be good, because if they go now to 2 here, if they have like 1 kilo of bounce spell, okay, they will go to 2 and now Diecraft Scavenger will be lethal. And then I will just get I'll get the swamp here. Yeah, they had these red cards, but very decent red cards there, but they didn't draw their mountain early enough. Alright, so this is all pretty I mean, they can have a they're not gonna have anything for one I mean one red that gains them life or anything, so let's just get rid of this and that's game over right away. Alright. Again, a pretty decent hand, but it does require the second black at some point. Okay, a lot of lantern bearers in these matches, but at least I get to maybe exile it from the graveyard. Blue and white this time. So there's the another black, that's good. So I'll just attack here and then maybe use one of these instants at their turn, depending on what they do. Oh, that's like a three colors there. Sure. If they don't play anything, I don't have any reason to play myself anything either. So let's just do all this and still see if they have an instant. They did not have an instant. What are they holding? Wow. Seems like a counterspell actually. Wow. So. I mean, I have land drops here, so I can just play the slow game here. There's no really reason for me to do much anything here. So both are having... I mean, they think I have a counterspell, but I think they have a counterspell for sure. I'm not gonna play in the Siphon Essence, I'm not gonna lose my Diagraph Scavenger. So let's just continue this weird little game here. If I knew they don't have a counterspell on the scavenger, I would definitely, you know, kill this with a parasitic grasp and then use the scavenger, but I'm not gonna have this thing countered. I need to draw something less significant that can get countered, because I'm pretty sure they're gonna have a Siphon Essence, unless they're sitting on some mass removal spell or something. Well, talk about an interesting limited game. Okay, Bioloom egg, sure. That's an egg right there. So they definitely have a Siphon Essence there because they played a 3-mana card, left a 3-mana open here. I think it's exactly Siphon Essence, not even a a syncopate, because of course I could play around syncopate here. So, am I supposed to kill the egg before they get value out of it? I mean, I could just play the Chill of the Grave, but it's not really very good on the egg here. I'm actually gonna do this because this egg will be an annoying card if they get to transform it. Okay, now I have the Mind Leech Goal, and I can use now. I can make them counter that now. Oh, they did it actually. What? That's no Siphon Essence. So are they just having lands in hand? I'm no longer understanding what's going on. Okay, they exiled a planes. Right, so it's just weird stuff. I could play the scavenger and eat my own dissenter, but I'd rather actually kill the lantern bearer. And then use the scavenger on it. Currently I'm having 4 power here. I'm winning this race now. I don't have to do anything to the lantern bearer. They need to play something which I can tap. Yeah, that can't quite get killed, so I'm just gonna tap that thing. Okay, scattered thoughts. So I think I'm also going to get rid of this guy now. And use this scavenger here, and then I can refill with this, maybe even draw my palm rare. I get to dig to 4 cards deep with this thing. Okay, I don't think they're gonna do anything with one red here, are they? Flame Blessed Bolt. Well, they can do that. Sure. It's done. And now I'll just play the scavenger here. Okay, rejection will be interesting too. Get rid of the flying aura here, and then don't have any wolf or werewolf yet. This is a vampire, of course. But now I'm, of course, winning the race currently. Screaming Swarm will be bounced, most likely. I think I should just play this first. Get a little bit of information. Alright, well, that's a bunch of decent... Okay, can I get all 4 of them? Maybe the Gift of Fangs isn't quite that good, but still. Rotite Gargantua is going to be quite nice with the Skull Scarf. I really like the Whispering Wizard here too, but they have a 4-4 flyer, so it's not maybe that great. I'm gonna have the Skull Scarf and the Gargantua. And then I will actually just bounce this guy. Attack for 4, and then if they play it again, I can use the Skull Scarf and the Gargantua. They will have to sacrifice one of these guys, and they still can only trade with the scavenger because of the death touch. And I just got 4 cards deep to my deck, so I have 18 cards left. One of them is my first pick in the draft. Okay, they chose to attack with the 4-4. Wonder what's that gonna mean now. Upgrade on the scavenger. Okay, and then they have a 5 mana left. Do they have a land swarm? Okay, they had none of that kind. So hopefully they won't have anything that... Okay, rejection there, that's fine. And then I can play the Skull Scarf. And the Gargantua. They have to sacrifice the Celebrants there. And I'll still get a 2-2 token out of the scarp here. But this swarm is gonna keep coming back, but I guess I need my demon here. That'll seal the deal. Rending Flame on there, okay, more removal then. Well, their deck has a bunch of removal, and that's a really decent card for that kind of a deck. But I guess I get this good draw here now, so I can keep dealing damage. But sadly, I won't be able to... I mean, with these land draws, it's not gonna be good enough. I need to draw my specific rare here. I don't think any other card will help me here at all. They don't even play the 6-6 mana card here. For what reason is that? Am I going to kill the Entomber here, make them exile a card? The 2-2s will be useless after the Weary Prisoner is gonna do its thing. Okay, I'll just get rid of this. It's not a vampire, it's a zombie. So it's -2/-2. Oh, they have a Scattered Thought, so the Mind Leech Goal will not do anything much. Okay, this is really bad. They milled 2 lands, they might easily have a 3rd land in hand. Alright, well... That's really bad. I'm not even sure if I should play the Mind Leech Goal now anymore. I'm not even sure if sacrificing the zombie is making any sense here. I think I'm not gonna play anything right now. I played a spell already, so it's also important not to make it into a knight and allow this to attack as a 6-6. But that Scattered Thoughts allowing them to refill there, and now more card draw even. This is really bad if I don't draw my first pick. I need to have my first pick now. Yeah, they had too much answers for my things. It looked like a good stuff at some point, but they were able to kill my 5-4 with them. My Rending Flame, and then they had to upgrade for my 2-3 Death Toucher. Yeah, this is... They still don't even play this 4-4 here, which is... not great. Okay, I really wish I could... attack for 2 here, but I can't even do that. I get to draw a card, so... Dreadfist Demon. Okay, Stitched Assistant. Fine, I'll play it now. They can bounce the toe 2 in response, I guess, but... okay. Let's get the demon now. Scry 1, draw a card. That is... it's kinda okay, but it's really not what I need here. I need the demon. The only card that will win me the game is the demon here. Sadly, even the Lantern Bearer isn't going to be enough because they have the 4-4 flyer in there. Yeah, there's no point really now playing the Mindless Skull yet. They have 3 cards that might be just complete nonsense. Do I have more Lunar Rejections? No, I don't have more Chill of the Graves. I have both Rejections, Chill of the Graves, I have the Bleed Dry. I don't think I have any way to deal with the 4-4 other than just drawing my own demon here. They discarded their prisoner here to draw another card. They discard an island to draw another card. Okay. They have 10 cards left, so I mean they're not gonna take out. With these cards they have in hand, they are gonna be in a winning position. But I still have a few draw steps to find my demon here. Okay, that's gonna get exiled. Well, okay, well that's actually good use for this Mindless Skull here. And they need to, of course, I mean this can't block the assistant, so they need to have something. But why wouldn't they have? They have 4 mana and so many cards in hand. So obviously they can deal with the assistant here. Oh, but I can do one thing here. I can make this fly and deal 4. Do I have my other scavenger still left? I think this is one. Because I have 2 in my deck. Okay, scavenger will win. Okay, although this is actually fantastic. So, I don't think one blue mana is gonna do anything. They also have, by the way, this kind of a decking prevention here, but this is great. I get to sacrifice this and I can make the assistant fly for 4 damage. And in fact, they exile an island from their hand. And in fact, this actually just trades with the swamp, but they can get the swamp back. So, not so great for me. But I mean, now my Diacrab Scavenger is going to be a lethal draw too. So not only the Dreadfist Demon, but the Diacrab Scavenger is going to be good. I will use the Evolving Wilds just to see what my deck has. So I will get rid of it. It will have 4 lands. There's the Demon and the Scavenger. These are the only things that can do anything. Demon and Scavenger. So, sorry, this and this. The others won't be enough to win the game. So, that is 2 outs in 9 cards. And I have a few draw steps here. They actually exile the swarm because they can get it back too. I'm sure they can be able to deal with the Stitched Assistant here. But hey, 2 outer out of 9 cards with multiple draw steps before I die. Yeah, I do like my chances now. Now that they had the imprisonment there. What is the white splash though? Is it only the imprisonment? That's the only white card I've seen so far. Couple of planes and I mean, I guess they have some white bomb here. Why would they just splash a couple of imprisonments? I haven't even seen any mana fixing there. It's only a basic land mana base. Well, I assume they have a white bomb of some kind there. Scarp, which they can use to get, I mean, one of many things back. They have at least a fine upgrade, if nothing else. They can get rid of the Stitch Assistant. Or, I mean, this is slightly better, I guess. And now, two outs. Come on. That is not quite good, but it is something I can use to, you know, block their guys. So, not so bad. Two outs out of eight cards, so that is... they can, of course, have a counterspell. Now, that's obviously true, but I mean, that's something I can't avoid. I mean, if they have a counterspell, then they have it, and then I have no chance to win. Unless I draw both of my outs, and they have only one counterspell. But yeah, this is not so bad, because now I can keep blocking the repository scarp here. Without taking damage. Forwarding statue, not so great at this stage in the game. Okay, Mind Leech goal. Well, I mean, let's make them exile a card from their hand. I can have the specimen here. What do they exile there? A land, okay. This specimen will enter tapped though, but it's fine, I'm at 15 here. And they can't really, and they need to have blockers for my attacks. I mean, each creature I have will be lethal. So now 2 out of 7 will be game-winning things. They chose to put the Screaming Swarm back on top, which is of course the thing they're gonna use to win the game, so that makes sense. They can also mill my outs, but of course they can also mill me so that I get closer to my outs, so that actually doesn't really affect their odds in any way. Because somewhere around these 7 cards are 2 cards that will be... Oh, they have another Screaming Swarm. So now are they gonna... No, they can't attack because I have 3 attackers. I guess they can attack with one creature. They can attack with one creature, but I'm also gonna get... Oh, they play the Screaming Swarm next turn and I lose. Because I get taken out. Oh. Yeah, because they both will trigger there. Ha. Okay, I need my Scavenger. And they must not have a Siphon Essence. Wow, I mean, I'm gonna get milled here by so many cards. Yeah, the double swarm is really... I mean, I guess I just never drew my outs. I was having 9 cards at some point, 2 of which were outs, but the top 3 went. And now the Dreadfish Demon isn't actually gonna win even the game. So, now that they had another swarm there, they're gonna just attack with everything and I'm gonna, you know, get milled by a bunch, so there's no point continuing. It's annoying enough how the game went. Sometimes you just don't draw you out, that's how it goes. Well, I won one game and I of course can still win more, but the deck doesn't seem that great. That was a game where I could have still won if I had like slightly better draws. Well, this could be a good hand if the Gift of Fangs will be buying me a lot of time. Or it can be a miserable hand if these are not gonna do much. This is of course is a keep because I have both colors and 3 lands and a mana curve here. Well, there is something for the Gift of Fangs, so that's fine. I'm gonna use the first one on this guy right away. Toxic Scorpion. Well, that's going to be... I mean, I'm gonna just trade with it. Don't think it makes any sense to use the Fangs on that. I assume they're gonna have something with 2 toughness. Or they're gonna choose that, which is going to be... I mean, I'm gonna now try to deal 2 here. Do I want to leave the chill here up? I guess I might want to leave it up. Don't really have a lot of pressure here, but Well, they can also bounce a wolf if they have a wolf or a werewolf here. They had nothing. Okay, I get to draw a lot of lands here, apparently. Well, let's thin the deck with this guy. I mean, my 2-2 isn't gonna beat any... Okay, I don't know. I no longer understand what's going on. They have 5 cards, 2 colors, and 4 mana total. Are they gonna just play around some kind of counter spells? No, it can't be. I mean, this is fine. If I get to attack with this 2-2 for a couple of turns, I will win. At least we'll be in a better position to win. Are they playing 3-color deck? Wow. Well, maybe I can now draw the Dreadfeast Demon. I have the mana for that, but this, my draws haven't been amazing, but of course I can't whine when the opponent is choosing to do nothing. I can't imagine their hand is full of 5+ mana cards. So they will get an annoying 1-1 token anyway, but... whatever, let's kill it. I don't want to bounce it because then they get another 1-1 token. Come on, deck. Gargantua will be good, but I need to probably bounce the 1-1 token, and then the Gargantua will be good. Okay, this is great. Now I don't have to bounce anything. So, of course, I could just play the 5-4 here, but they can have a bleed dry. I think it's better value to use the 2-2 as a, you know, make them sacrifice a creature. Which I assume is gonna be something big. I mean, they could have a land and a 6-6, for instance. They can have that too. So I could... Nah, I'm just gonna use the... Alright, well, this is actually even better now. I'm not gonna gamble and attacking here. Let's do just this thing and then the Gargantua here. Decline this, but this I won't be declining. Okay, so I get to... still get my 2-2 back. I know I could have sacrificed the Skull Scarab instead and attack for 2, but I might draw some other exploit stuff still. Let's see if they have a bleed dry. Oh, there's a third color, which I'm not surprised to see because they just didn't do anything early in the game. So with my 2 interaction spells and the 9 power I have here, I do like my chances. Now I assume they have some removal for the Gargantua. But that will tap most of their mana, and I still have 4. Get Millipede here. So let's just... let's do this, because I don't have mana for this, but it doesn't matter. Okay, Whispering Wizard, yeah, amazing draw, of course. I think this is going to win the game to me now, because they are gonna go down to 3. This won't untap. I'll play the land in case they play a wolf here. And now I have the 1-1 flyer they need to deal with. I mean, they need to deal with this entire board, not just the 1-1 flyer. But they might have their 6-6 that gains them 6 life now. But if that's the case, they will have 1 mana left over and they will be at 9 and I will bounce at the 6-6 and they will still lose. Unless the 1 mana they have left over does something. But it's quite unlikely. Maybe some rare can will win the... That's a rare, but that doesn't do anything if you don't have tokens. So many souls trapped on this plane. They don't deserve death touch, and that doesn't do it. I mean, that's literally nothing. Just how I showed okay. You got this. Right. Well, that was a weird game. But hey, I'm now at 2 wins, and now my premier drafts, they are either 7 wins or 2 wins. So I expect to lose the next game. That's really... If you saw my draft after draft number 40, I had my statistics. There's a lot of 7 wins and a lot of 2 wins for my premier draft. So this would continue the trend if that's gonna happen. All right. So I guess with the specimen and the my ditch goal, this is maybe keepable. If I get the blue mana, I will get to draw some cards. I'm gonna do it, because this deck isn't so great that I'm gonna have to maybe have this a little bit of a gamble keep here. If I draw an island soon-ish, this will be still fine. Of course, if I don't draw any. So I think the 1-1 is just less impactful, that I'm gonna sacrifice it to make them exile a card from their hand, and my next land draw could be a swamp, and that doesn't even allow me to cast any of these spells, so the persistent specimens can be then returned in that case. Wait a second, they have 39 cards in their deck. Okay, they play Morton. They play more than 40 cards, so that's... Okay, I mean, 39 in the deck, 1 in exile, 5 in hand, so 45. They have 48 card deck, and I drew the island here. That's pretty nice. So I think I'll most likely get the specimen back, but who knows, maybe I will use the tricks here as well. Sheltering bows. Well, that's fine. I mean, I can't prevent the card draw because this is not a wolf or werewolf. If it was, that would have been sweet. And I will do it like this and see if I draw a land. I can bounce it. I do, so let's do it. Attack for 3 here. So yeah, this is game number 6 in the event. And Red Feast Demon hasn't done anything so far. Let's see if I can finish the event without ever getting to play that thing. There was one game when it was in my hand. Alright, that's not fair. There was one game where it was in my hand, and there was another game where I had the mana, but it never drew it, even though I had only, what? 7 cards left in the deck, but it wasn't in the top 33 cards. Now, yeah, let's just offer the trade. If they really want to block the 1-1, I'm actually quite happy. And I think the scavenger... can't currently exile anything. But I mean, it's a 2-3 death toucher. I mean, it can exile, but it doesn't can't exile a creature here, so... So it's still a 2-3 death toucher, and I can use these things to, you know, make way for my guys. But of course, the wedding announcement is gonna be a bit of a problematic thing, because now they will have 2 tokens, and they have an imprisonment there. I guess that I can bounce to my own hand. Well, let's see what I draw. Well, I mean, them sacrificing 1-1 isn't that bad, really. Because it will be a 2-2 on the next turn. So I think I'd just rather sacrifice the scavenger, although I could sacrifice the specimen too, but... Well, I don't think I'm gonna do anything pre-combat. Just do this. Okay, they jump up with the 1-1. That's actually... That, I'm sure, wasn't the correct play, because it's soon a 2-2, and now I mean, they were still at 11 here. Blue-black isn't really exactly the kind of archetype that can get surprise damage too much, at least not in this format. So I do want to play my 5-4 here, and I don't think I'm gonna bother with bouncing my own scavenger, so I will just sacrifice that thing. Keep the specimen here. Now they're gonna sacrifice the other 1-1. They will still get 1 token there, and of course their creatures will be bigger, but I have a couple of interaction spells here. And again, the same story goes that if I draw my Dreadfist Demon, it will basically win the game unless they have a mass removal spell. Okay, Skullscarp. Oh, okay, I can make the specimen into a 2-2. So the 5-4, it's just gonna trade with the Geist here. I think it's time to just play the rejection there. Or maybe... No, this is better now. Because I can do it like this. And then, oh, that's gonna be good too. And then I can attack with the 5-4. If they double block, I can bounce the 2-2 and then eat the 3-3. They just jump, which is, I mean, that's actually fine for me too. So now am I gonna rather play the Scattered Thoughts or the Skull Scarp here? If I had a fifth land, it would be easy Skull Scarp, then I could return this thing, but I might maybe have a land drop or something. Maybe I will do this. But maybe I wanna see what they do first. Okay, I wanna see what they do. So I'm gonna play this end of turn. Late end of turn, but I'm really happy they just jump block with a couple of the tokens. They still have a bunch of... Sadly, they have a bunch of spells left, so it's not over. And they have 11 life. And these colors can have life gain too. Yeah, okay. I'll take 3. Wonder what's up with that. There it is. I don't have 7 lands yet, but I mean, I'm gonna draw a land at some point, so... The assistant is actually quite nice with the Skull Scarp. Alright, Parasitic Grasp. Alright, so now this is somewhat interesting. They can have a Witch's Web there easily, but I have a bounce spell for that. So no reason to do anything but attack with everyone here. Can't kill with the Grasp, but I can bounce it. It would be funny if they had another one for the Disciple and then I can play the Prat, because it's a human, so I can do this. If they don't have a pump spell here, this is... Wow, look at this turn. Pretty fantastic. So, it's actually so that I'm not gonna even need the Dreadfist Demon here after all. Didn't need the Demon here. Hey, I got my third win. I said in the deck building, after deck building, that I'm happy if I get the 3 wins. And I got it now. So, I guess that's satisfactory now. Well, I'm keeping it because I can draw some synergy for this and still the deck isn't that great. I don't have that great, you know, dream starts with this deck, so I'm gonna keep these a little bit worse hands now, because I feel like I need to be a bit lucky here. I don't know, this is actually not so bad. I can maybe kill their 2-drop here with Gift of Fangs, but they don't have any. Alright, well, I mean, then I can use the Bleed Dry even, and this is actually the kind of card that was a perfect draw for the Gargantua, so actually I like my chances now. Unless they have like a wedding announcement as well. Please don't have a nice bomb rare there. Spiked Ripsaw, sure. Okay, well, I mean, I don't have the fifth land. I might need to use the tapping effect here. Or just the play. Okay, they are Naya colors. Right. What's this mountain? Oh, these are the some special lands. Hopefully initiate. Well, that can be killed. They can actually... Right, they can do that. So, what I should do here is... If I knew my top land, top card was a land, it would be so good. If it's not... Okay, I'm gonna just draw a card here. I feel like that's what I need to do. Okay, well, there's a demon. And there is still no land, so, well, interesting, really interesting. I think I need to use the Bleed Dry here on this turn. rather than play a one mana card. But now the game plan is obviously just to get to 7 lands. And so far it seems like it'll be possible. Opponent isn't really pressuring me at all and I have some interaction here. Okay, well that is good for the Gift of Fangs. I actually have to, as annoying as it is, but I have to do it like this. Funny, just don't seem to get there. But this is actually a good turn. This is actually a good turn, so I can do it like this. Let's attack for one. Then I will use the Mind Leech goal. I know I could use it to kill the Lantern Bearer too, but maybe I don't. I'll get my 2-2. And then I will play the Gift of Fangs post-combat, not giving them the information. So they have to exile a card from the hand now. And then the Lantern Bearer will be a good sacrifice on the Gargantua at some point when I actually am gonna draw. Yeah, please don't be another game where I have like 4 lands for 15 draws and still don't have the 7th. Only 4 lands at currently. What the exiled. Massive Might, alright. So Gift of Fangs on there. This guy, another vampire. And this thing. This thing has training, but no one trains it currently. But yeah, I'm happy if I draw 3 lands back to back now. Oh. This thing has even first strike. Darn. I wish I had my Gift of Fangs now. I mean, there's no attack. I can't even attack with... I guess I can make them block with the Rural Recruit and then use the Gift of Fangs there, but it's just a horrible thing. I think I need to attack with the Lantern Bearer just to, you know, put it to my graveyard. They can block with the... They can just take one here too, but they can block with the Hallowed Andalina because it is... It has reach. And it has first strike, so I mean, imagine if it didn't have first strike. How great would it be to, you know, it deal one damage there and... Okay, this is really horrible. They can now, you know, put the Ripsaw on the Hallowed Andalina. This will get 5 counters in that case, because it gives counters equal to its power. Right. Well, I mean, I thought I was gonna win with the Dreadfist Demon, but they had their own... Alright. They had their bomb and now I'm just losing here. I mean, I can double block this. I can take 19 and go to 1. Or I can jump block here. But there's just... I'm not beating the Hal. And even if... it's too late at this point to kill the Hal and Alina, even if we had something, because they have a 7-7 and a 4-4. And this thing has training, so it'll be bigger. So, yeah. Well, that was my first pick in the draft. Never got to play it. The 2 games where I had in my hand, I didn't get the 7 lands. And the one, and the couple of games where I did have both it in my hand and the mana for it in the previous game, but that was unnecessary. But then there was the one game where I was at about 10 lands or something and had 7 cards left in the deck, still didn't draw the demon. So sometimes the bum rest just don't really show up. And that also tells, how much better something like Hallowed and Alina is, because if your bum rare costs 4, you get to play this thing if you just draw it. If your bum rare costs 7, it's obviously not so straightforward. But that game was kind of weird because I was almost sure that with my hand I can buy enough time to, you know, get the 7 mana. But then I just never drew the 5th land for both of my Gargantuas. If I did draw the Gargantua if I was able to play the Gargantuas, the Helena and Alina couldn't have pumped any creature there. And I could have made them sacrifice a couple of creatures, and then maybe go to the seven lands and then fill the board with the 6/6 flyers. But nope, that just wasn't to happen. But still, the three wins getting me at least 1,000 gems back and a couple of packs is fine, because the deck was really not good. So I think I needed more of those good uncommons to make this deck really good. And just, you know, maybe more removal. Although I had a Bleed Dry and I had a Parasitic Grasp, so what more can I ask? The blue-black isn't really that great of an archetype, but I'm not sure what I was supposed to do in the draft. I first picked the Demon, which, you know, made me draft black. And then I got some, you know, good black cards. This came quite late, in fact. And then blue was super open in pack one. And the rejections are decent. The Chill of the Graves are decent. Lantern Bearer is good, so... Yeah, I'm not sure if there was some other deck to be drafted. Even if I picked the Pax on Pop and the Outcast after that in pick 3, green did dry up a bit, so it wasn't really the way to go either. Maybe I'll check it from the 17 lands data, that if there was some other kind of deck to be drafted. Or maybe this is just that, you know, blue-black was open, but because the cards are not that great, it doesn't really give you good-looking decks, even if the color combination is open. But yeah, anyway, that is now enough of a rambling, and let's claim the prize here. Next draft will be a traditional draft, and also in the weekend I will be playing in this qualifier weekend event, so that will of course be coming to my channel too. Thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next video. Bye bye.